Here are the top 60 Linux commands you need to know. And we're gonna do this in 10 minutes. Our first command can be used anywhere. It's SSH, because you can't use Linux unless you can get to it. To connect to your Linux machine, you'll specify your username, then the @ symbol, and then the server you're gonna connect to. So I'll copy the IP address of my Linode that I just set up, paste that in here, hit enter, accept all fingerprints, put your password in, and we're in. The ls command will list all the files in your current working directory. We can add the l switch to give us a nice list, and we can add the a switch to see the hidden stuff. Now Linux is a big place. Where are you? With the pwd command, you can find out. Print working directory, it'll tell you where you are. But if you don't want to be there, we can change that with the cd command, change directory. Just after cd will tell it where we want to go, maybe the root of the file system. Whew, we made it, guys. Or we can specify a specific path. With cd dot dot, we can jump back one directory. And with cd space nothing, we can click our heels and get back home. Touch is the quickest and easiest way to create a file. Type in touch, put the file name in, you got yourself a file. We can create more than one file. Every one of those words in that sentence will be its own file. Or we can do something weird like this. Or we can even create a file in the future by using the -d switch and specifying the date it's created. A file from the future. And seriously, shout out to Linode for sponsoring this video. Whenever I need to do anything in Linux, I go to Linode and spin up a quick virtual machine to do stuff like this. And it only costs me 0.0075 cents an hour. When I'm done, I destroy it, and that's all I'm charged. Check it out, link below. The echo command allows you to talk to yourself. Or we can use it to add stuff to a file really quickly. We'll specify the right arrow and then a name of a file, a new or existing file. But if you really want to edit a file like a Linux pro, you'll use nano. Nano and then the file name, and boom, we're editing a file. To save your file with nano, you'll hit Control X, Y, and enter to save. Now, if you're a Linux pro that thinks you're better than everybody else, you'll use vim. Vim, the file name, and now you can try to edit a file. The best way is to hit I to start inserting text. And once you're done, hit Escape, colon, and WQ to write and quit. Now, if you want to see what's inside a file really quickly, use the cat command. Cat and then the file name, super fast. And if you don't want anyone to ever see what's in that file, you can shred it. Shred the file name and cat that one again. Nothing. Looks like a cat wrote it. We can make a new directory with the mkdir command. But right now it's empty, it's lonely. So let's copy something in there. We can copy a file with the cp command. We'll specify our file and then where we want it to go. If you don't want to copy, you can use the mv command to move the file. Specify the file you want to move and then where you want to put it. We can remove or delete a file with the rm command. And we can remove a directory with the rmdir command. But if it's not empty, we can go back to the rm command and do a -r for recursive and try that. Done. We can create a link to a file with the ln command. And using the s switch for soft, we'll specify the file and then the link. Now if your terminal's a bit dirty, you can clean it off. Type in clear. Ah, so much better. Coffee break. If you don't know who you are, you can type in who am I, and it'll tell you. Existential crisis over. If you don't like who you are, you can change that. Let's first create a new person. We'll use the adduser command and then the username. Oh, too bad. We don't have permission, but we have sudo or sudo. Specify sudo before your command, enter your sudo password, and you're good to go. We can also reverse the command by doing adduser instead of useradd, and we'll be able to set some parameters like passwords and stuff. Now, if I want to become Nick or Austin, I can do that with the su command for switch user. SU, specify the username, and I am Austin. If I don't want to be Austin anymore, I can use the exit command. Type in exit, back to being me. And by the way, the exit command can be used to exit out of a lot of places. Now, Nick didn't have a password, but I can change that with the password command. PASSWD, and then the username. If you want to change your password, just type in password or password.
Type into the terminal, sudo password milli. But it's just password.
Now, this next command is kind of weird, and you'll have to install it. It's called finger. It's really strange, trust me. But to install that, we'll need to learn a new command. On Debian-based machines, we'll use apt. But hold up, before we can install anything, we have to update our repository. So we'll do sudo apt update. While it's doing that, we'll take a coffee break. If you're on Red Hat or CentOS, you'll use the yum package manager. And if you're on Arch or anything else, you're on your own. After an update, we'll do a sudo apt install and the name of our package, which will be finger. Done. And now we can use that command. Finger can be used to inspect another user. So I might want to inspect Austin. It's pretty handy. The man command will help you with things you don't know, which is a lot, at least for me. You can find out what the finger command does by doing man finger. That sounds weird. It'll tell us all about it and how to use it. Hit Q to get out of there. We can man cat. We can man man. So when in doubt, consult your manual. Now a faster man is whatis. Type in whatis finger. It'll tell you real quick. Or maybe you want to know where finger is. You can type in which finger, which will tell you one place, but you want to know where all the fingers are. So say where is finger. Wget can help you get stuff from the internet. Like maybe you want to download the entire Bible in text form. We can do that right now. And there it is, the entire Bible. Another way to download is with curl, my personal favorite. Type in curl, the URL you want to download from, and then using the right arrow direct that to something else, like a file. Done. Now the Bible's kind of big. What do you say we make that file smaller? We can zip it up. Zip, the zip file you want to create, and what you want to zip inside. Hey, that wasn't too bad. Now often you might want to unzip something with the unzip command. Specify that file name and some other options, and you're good to go. Now, if we want to read our file, we could cat it. But that's crazy, come on. A better way is using the less command, giving you one page at a time, just the way I like it. If you only want to see the beginning of your file, type in head. What about the end? Type in tail. If you want to compare two files to see if they are the same, like this guy and this guy, use the cmp command for compare. Specify your two files, and hey, we do have a difference. But it didn't tell us what, it only told us where. For that, we can use the diff command. Specify our files, and it will tell us exactly what's different. You decide what's true. The sort command will sort your stuff alphabetically. So for example, I could cat the Bible, do a pipe, and type in sort at the end. The entire Bible in alphabetical order, ending with Zephaniah. The find command is nuts and will help you, well, find things. Type in find, specify what directory you want to look in. I'm going to look in all of them. And then specify a name of a file with a regular expression. Bam, files found. You can also find all hidden files, empty directories, or all executable files. And speaking of executable, how do you make a file executable? We'll change the attributes with the chmod command and do a plus x, and then the file name. And now it executes. We can change the ownership of that file with the chown command, or change ownership. Specify the user, and then the file. Congrats, Austin, you own a file. Time for some network stuff, coffee break. What's your IP address? ifconfig. If you don't have it, install it. Let's try it again, ifconfig. There it is. You could also try IP address, which makes more sense. Same information, just better. Now what if you only want to see it for one interface? For that, we can use grep. Grep is crazy. I love grep. Same command, IP address. But this time we'll use a pipe, type in grep, and say ethernet 0 to only see ethernet 0's IP address. Bam! We could grep again. Do another pipe, grep for inet, and it only shows you that line. But what if we only want to see the IP address? For that, we can use awk. Awk is even crazier than grep. Just after our greps, I'll awk this, put in a crazy regular expression, and get exactly what I want. Now what about DNS? What's our DNS server? One way is we can cat it. Cat the etc resolve with no e dot conf file. But if you're on newer versions of things like Ubuntu, you might see something like this. Not very informative. Instead, we can type in resolve with an e, ctl status. And there it is. Now, is your website up? We can find out with ping. We can find out if anything's up with ping. Ping and then the name of the website. We'll get responses forever. Hit control C to stop it. We can limit that with a -c command specifying the count of things we want to send. Just 5. We can specify the size of the packet. If you want to see the path through the internet you're taking to get to a website, you can use the traceroute command, which is so cool. Traceroute, and then the name of the site, telling you every hop and that latency. Now what ports are open on your Linux machine? We can check it out with netstat, net statistics. This gives you a lot. So you might want to try netstat-tulpin, all those switches, which is much better. A more modern version is the ss command, which is basically the same thing. Use the tulpin switches, and it's nice and pretty. Now what about your firewall? Are things getting through, or do you want to block them? If you wanted to allow port 80, you could run something like this, which is honestly kind of complex. That's why UFW is way easier. This sits on top of IP tables and makes it so much easier. If I want to allow port 80, just do UFW allow 80 as sudo. Done. See what you're allowing with UFW status, which right now it's not even enabled, so we can enable it with UFW enable. Then check our status once more. Beautiful. Now if you want to know a bit more about your system, you can use the uname command. Uname, it'll tell you just a little bit. If you type in dash a, it'll tell you a lot. Now if you want a prettier version of all this, try neofetch. I'm going to install that real quick. apt install neofetch, and then simply run neofetch. And how pretty is that? The cal command will give you a quick little calendar here. I don't know why you'd want that, but it's kind of cool. If you don't have it, you can install it with sudo apt install ncal. If you want to do some math right here in your terminal, you can echo a problem out to bc, and bc will tell you what the answer is. If you want to check on your memory and see how much memory you have available on your system, just type in free. It'll tell you what's used and what's going on with your swap. How much disk space do you have? You can use the df command, and more specifically the df-H command. You're gonna use that one all the time. What about the stuff running on your system, the processes? We can use the ps command, which won't tell you much unless you use the ps-aux switch. Then we get all the goodies. If you wanna see the processes eating up all your stuff, type in top. If you wanna see that in a prettier way, type in htop. That's slick. If you have a process that you want to kill, stop it. We can do that with the kill command. First, we have to find the process ID. I'll do that with ps. I'll grep for that script I want to kill. There it is. There's his process ID. And I'll kill the process with the -9 signal, forcibly killing it, and then the process ID, 6659. Goodbye, buddy. He's gone. Now, even better than kill is pkill, because you don't need to know the process ID. Type in pkill, use the F switch, and specify the name you kind of think it is. And it did it. To stop, start, and restart services or daemons in Linux, you can use the systemctl command if your system's using systemd. If not, it'll be using service. So to stop a service, systemctl stop, we'll do Apache 2, replace stop with start, we'll start the service, type in status to see what's going on, or do a restart. Now we've gone through a lot of commands. If you want a history of all we did, type in history. And that's a lot of stuff. And finally, if you want to reboot, sudo reboot. If you want to shut down, sudo shut down. This will shut down your machine in about 1 minute. If you want to do it now, do a -h now, which I'll do. That's the end of the video. Talk to you guys later.